मङ्गलसे नगरपालिका पानीको एउटा स्रोतै मानिन्थ्यो पहिले, अहिले गएर असाध्य अभावग्रस्त भइरहेको छ। अहिले केही वर्ष यतादेखि बर्सात पनि धेरै कम पर्ने र पानीका मुहानहरू पनि सुक्दै गएको परिस्थिति छ। साथसाथै अहिले नयाँ पानी उम्रिने कुराहरू पनि धेरै कम भएको छ।
चार पाँच वर्षभन्दा अगाडि समयमा पानी आउँथ्यो, समयमा खेत रोपिन्थ्यो र समयमा किसानी काम गर्थ्यो, तरकारी पनि समयमा फल्थ्यो। अहिले त्यस्तो छैन। जेठमा रोपिने खेत असाढमा गएछ, असाढमा रोपिने अहिले पनि 10-15 गते रोपिने खेत अहिलेसम्म रोपिया छैन।
हाम्रो लेखबाट पनि हामीलाई पाइन मुस्किलै छ, अरू ठाउँमा जाने ठाउँै छैन हाम्रो।
अब के एउटा गाडी लगिन्छ 10 लिटरको 5 लिटरको, उही भर्न नि बिहान अनारेमा गएपछि 9 बजे 10 बजे घर गरिनुपर्छ।
Recently, there's this perception that springs are drying out, and we don't really know the reason for this. It could be impact of climate change, it could be because of land degradation, it could be because of new construction, new road construction. So under this context, and because springs are such an important source of water, especially in these mountain areas, in these upper watersheds, IMI, my institute, International Water Management Institute, together with NDF, ADB, Department of Forest and Soil Conservation, we undertook a 5-year study. It was called BCRWME. The funding came from the Climate Investment Funds to studied springs, so basically tried to understand spring hydrology, the processes that recharge springs, in order to make recommendations, in order to plan watershed interventions that are targeted at recharging springs.
In the 5-year research project that IMI led under the BCRWME project, we looked at springs in 2 pilot sites, Shikharpur Baithari and Bon Lake Doti. In each of these sites, we looked at 4 different springs. We gathered data on the rainfall, temperature and other climatic parameters, and the spring discharge using automatic hydrological and meteorological stations. In addition to this, we used satellite data to analyze the land cover characteristics of the 2 sites. We conducted field surveys to understand the hydrogeology, and then we conducted for the first time in Nepal the isotope tracer study to identify where the water is coming from in these springs. We use isotopes to identify the ideal recharge zones to inform the design of effective implementations to help revive these springs. In addition to all of these, we also looked at climate projections for all of far west Nepal to speculate the impact of climate change on these springs.
Thank you.
from the isotope analysis as well as all the monitoring we did in the last 5 years, it's what we recommend or what we conclude is it's very important to characterize the springs. Some springs are fed mainly by groundwater. Some are fed by direct precipitation. They're, you know, very closely connected, and some are a mix between the two. So when you're planning your interventions, you need to understand the typology of the spring. So if it's being fed by groundwater or surface water or interflow, etc. And the other main point is basically the source of the spring can be outside of your direct spring shed or watershed. So any intervention done in that watershed, it does not ensure that the spring from that watershed will be recharged, because the sources can be, you know, outside the watershed. And this is why we recommend a larger landscape approach. So basically try to integrate the management of all natural resources, including land, trees, I mean forestry, maintaining forests are very important, and people, of course, and move away from the sectoral management. And also integrate the management of both the groundwater resources as well as surface water resources, because, you know, spring flow, it's part of this whole groundwater surface flow continuum.